Hello, and welcome again to Amazing Mind. If you've just joined us, we have as our second guest, Marcela Ewertz. Now, Marcela is an honors grad of HMI College of Hypnotherapy. She is also a recipient of the prestigious Director's Award. Marcela is a renowned artist, and she is published in the book of International Contemporary Artists. And today, she's going to talk to us about intuitive painting in hypnotherapy. Please help me welcome my guest. Marcela, can you tell us a little bit about your works and your art?
Yes, Lisa. My work is based on intuitive painting, which is a method that I developed years ago to get into the subconscious mind by allowing things to happen naturally so that I could gain inspiration.
Can you tell us something about this painting that we see right now?
Yes, Lisa. This painting is called The Face of a Lie. And it was a very meaningful painting for me at the time because I was going through a period of deception, feeling vulnerable and very hurt. So as I was painting one day, I suddenly found a way to access my subconscious mind where I found all the necessary comfort and truth that I needed to learn about from this experience, such as being aware all the time, such as trusting more, and such as, more than anything else, trusting myself.
So from being an artist and being a hypnotherapist, tell me about the new program that you've developed. Actually, it's not so new. You've been doing it for over 20
years. I've been doing it for a number of years because I used to be a therapist in other holistic areas of my life
Excellent.
As well.
And then you added hypnotherapy.
Exactly.
Tell me about the intuitive painting hypnotherapy program.
The intuitive painting program was designed by me years ago to allow the creative aspect to awaken in a person. Many people think that creativity is something that they don't have. However, creativity, the creative aspect, is an innate ability in all of us. So with that in mind, I created this program and to allow it to manifest. And the way it manifests is by accessing the subconscious mind where truth, where beauty, where everything, all of those knowns abide.
If someone came to one of your workshops, what would he or she experience?
In the beginning, whoever comes to a first workshop is a person who is reluctant to believe sometimes they have any creative power. So we start with a very simple process in which, first of all, we involve ourselves in exercises to attain calmness, through imagery, through relaxation, through even teaching them about the painting process, explaining things. And then as they get involved in the process themselves and they allow themselves to flow, even with the flow and the stream of acrylic glaze as they're putting it on paper, they get in touch with that area of their subconscious mind. The first thing that happens is an arousal of emotions, of feelings, when that happens actually, which could be surprise, it could be happiness, it could be disbelief of what they're seeing. And as the process goes by, at the very end, they find a finished piece with an outcome they never believed could come from themselves.
Well, I could see how this would alter the way that someone sees him or herself. For example, I think I'm a fine hypnotherapist, but I would be scared to come to a painting class. I would think, I can't do that. I'm not creative in that way. How does intuitive painting become a metaphor for other areas of people's lives? In other words, for people's limiting beliefs about themselves, like the one that I have.
Yes, well, let me tell you, Lisa, intuitive painting works pretty much like handwriting analysis through ideomotor responses. So once the person gets in touch with the subconscious mind, it manifests in the painting, giving that person a form of a mirror to their inner selves to which they can relate and they can talk to and receive responses at the same time.
I would like to see some examples of this. Can you take us through a client's evolution, starting with a first workshop that someone did? So as we look here at this next image, Marcela, can you tell us a little bit about this client and about this process?
Yes, I had this client about 10 years ago. This first image that you can see here is an image that she obtained, that she produced actually, on the first workshop when she was taken there by her daughter. This person, Toni Brock, was a very successful businesswoman at the time, very much a left brain person,
yes,
and who did not believe so much in the ability that she could have as a painter. It turns out, as you see, that it's a very professional looking image.
Yes, it is.
From that moment on, she said, this has been the best decision that I have taken in my life. From then on, she continued having private lessons with me for the next 3 years.
Can you tell us about the middle of her process of self-discovery and of art? Tell us about the second image.
I should have mentioned that the first piece she named Unsure, so that tells you a lot.
That tells us everything.
Now, the second piece that she started working on, you can see there are a number of symbols there. We are going to focus right now on the center symbol. She called this piece the path. And as the name implies, it was about finding her inner light.
What did she mean by that?
She meant that she was finding answers that she didn't know existed in herself. She was finding solutions for her everyday life that she had not found otherwise. But intuitive painting was giving her the tools to obtain that.
Can you explain that to me? Why would that work?
It would work because the images there work as metaphors.
Yes.
And so whatever the person was seeing, the way she was relating to her own work, she could take to her everyday life and she could focus on obtaining a similar result.
Marcela, I am a hypnotist, so I'm a hammer, and everything looks like a nail. What is the process of getting the conscious mind out of the way to get to creativity?
Well, the painting process itself is already a very valuable tool for that purpose, because people are not even conscious of the point in which, through their calmness and focusing on what they're doing, they just step into this passageway that takes them directly to the subconscious mind. And from then on, the creative process itself takes care of everything else.
I want to take a look and talk about this last image.
Yes. Well, this image happened quite some time later, actually. And it represents, you can see by the flow of it, that it there's a lot of lightness in it.
Yes.
It represents the ability for her to give in to her dreams, to feel that she was able to do anything. She could fly, she could do anything at that point, and feel that freedom within herself.
So, taking it to a very practical level, this woman defined herself when she came in for the first workshop as someone who's coming in just to placate her daughter, correct? And she perceived herself as a very successful businesswoman.
Yes.
How did her image of herself evolve and transform through her process of
working
with
you? Well, I don't know if you would like me to read a quote.
I would love that.
Okay, let me read it for you. She said at one point, I will, and happily so, never be the same person I was before attending Marcela's intuitive painting workshop. I have found what I can be and feel the peace that comes with such realization. Intuitive painting is a release into the freedom of calmness and serenity.
That's beautiful. That's beautiful. So, if we have someone in our office who is stuck, and all hypnotherapists, people in the mental health profession, sometimes we stumble upon that. In what way can intuitive painting unlock that block?
Well, every person needs a different way of approaching. So it would be the intuitive painting and the treatment themselves would be totally customized for the client. However, the process of intuitive painting is very much enriched by the use of hypnotherapy, using the intuitive painting as a tool for hypnotherapy.
The thing I like best is at the end of the day, you get to take home a tangible symbol or an anchor, if you will,
absolutely,
of your success.
Yes, definitely.
Marcela, everybody's going to want to know more about your unique program, intuitive painting, and your unique style of hypnotherapy. And you can reach Marcela on hmigrads.com. Well, it appears we're out of time for today. But first, before we leave, I want to again thank Marcela Ewertz, I got it
right,
for being a guest on my show and sharing her experiences. I want to thank everybody in our studio audience and everybody at home who's watching the show. I hope you'll stay tuned and join us next time when we continue to meet more people and explore the amazing mind. Stay tuned. We have a lot more coming up for you on Hypnosis TV.